Hello, welcome once again to another edition of the Coach's Corner program. I'm Jeff Ruth, along with Harding head coach John Brady. And John, a terrific crowd last Saturday night. Obviously, the results, though, not what you were looking for.
Great crowd. We knew it was going to be a great crowd. And our student section and I put on announcements today. They were great. They were outstanding. And our band, it was amazing. Both those groups were behind us the whole way, and I thank them very much for all support.
Last week, River Valley, the week before, Mount Vernon, we always talk about coaches say that, you know, that they see the most improvement or hope to see the most improvement from week one to week two. How did week two compare with week one?
Well, you know, I think the effort was there, no doubt about that. We had some missed tackles, and, you know, because we're in the wrong spots, but, you know, our kids still giving great effort, and, you know, we in the second half, we had some kids, our tailbacks, getting cramped up and things like that, so we were kind of low on personnel at the time, and then we lost some kids. Logan Crawford had a bad ankle sprain, and Roger Hamlin, another ankle sprain. But, you know, they're going to be back in maybe the end of this week or next week. But we came out okay, but we're just got to keep plugging along. And, you know, you got to give River Valley credit. You know, that's what a program's all about. He's built that program up to where last year he makes the playoffs for the first time, and now he's really on a roll with his team. And, you know, he had a lot of kids back from last year, and I say, again, they're a good football team, but they'll be another playoff contender.
Yeah. As we tape this, it's Tuesday afternoon. We're looking at, you know, 93, 94 today. It's going to be hot tomorrow. You know, the last couple of Friday nights, it's, you know, been warm and humid. It's really quite a contrast to the two-a-days you had back in August when it was really pretty comfortable.
Well, we'll have to work through it. I mean, everybody tonight's not going to cancel practice, yeah. So everybody in Ohio is going to practice in it. So we'll just have to work through it and do the best we can.
All right. We come back and take a look at some of the highlights from the contest against River Valley. We also have several of the players we're going to talk to a little bit later on the program. We'll do that right after these words. Reminder, you can catch the Coach's Corner show beginning Wednesday night at 8 o'clock and then continuing 4 o'clock in the morning and noon right on through the weekend.
Coach Winters is joining me. Looks like you could still put the helmet and the shoulder pads on and go out and play on Friday nights.
Getting a little too old, no eligibility left, and I leave it up to those young guys to take those beatings, and I put my time in, I'm done with that. So.
All right. Obviously, you enjoy coaching, though. You enjoy being around the kids.
I do love it, and that's one of the reasons when Coach Brady first got the job, I wanted to be a part of what was going on here, because you've known since midget football when you were playing the games back then that this is a town I really care about these kids, and just wanted to get back and get the program back to where it was.
Yeah, we didn't talk too much about it on the show last week, but Coach has really put together a nice list of some guys with a lot of experience, some of the older guys, and then guys like yourself and some of the other assistant coaches. And it's really a nice mix, and I think that works out well.
Yeah, I always told my dad, I said, I don't want to coach at all, but as soon as Coach Brady got that job and he called me up, I didn't hesitate at all, and I was one of the first people that wanted to be a part of this program and the things that are going to happen here in the future with it.
For our viewers, talk a little bit about what you do, Coach.
I coach wide receivers, and I help a little bit with the secondary. I played secondary here in high school, and then as I went to college, I played more wide receiver, so I'm more familiar with that position because I recently played it, and so I help with those guys, and I help on special teams as well.
You know, and to be an assistant coach, obviously, you got to know your position. It doesn't do anybody any good if they're going to put an assistant coach in. You know, if you were, you know, coaching the middle linebackers in the center or something like that.
I've never been a big guy, so it'd be real hard for me to relay to the things they go through. So I kind of try to stay on the outside, right, furthest away from the ball with the finesse players and the skill players and do the things that I know how to do well.
You know, after you've had a chance to see the film from Saturday night, kind of give me your assessment.
I watched the film. I think there was, like Coach Brady said, there was great effort. The scheme that we came up with is good, and all the respect in the world to River Valley. It's something that they've looked forward to for a while. They've been asking for the last 20 years, and they finally got their chance, and they did what they had to do. Our guys also, they played well, and like Coach Brady said, the weather and then the conditioning, you know, people were cramping up and things like that. So we'll get it taken care of and be back at it this week.
One of the keys last week was the fact they got on the scoreboard there late at the end of the second quarter, and then they came out and got the kickoff to start the third quarter and scored. I thought those two drives were just huge.
Yeah, I think, you know, scoring at the end of the half and then scoring at the beginning kind of got the momentum going in their way, and it just kind of they started separating themselves from us, and you know, later on we still had kids fighting until the very end.
Oh, yeah.
And I was so proud of the guys for, you know, all the way until the last whistle they were still fighting, and we finally got to see some emotion after the game. Some of the kids were upset and really crying, and that let me know that, you know, they're not out there to just, you know, just to play ball, but they really do care about the end result. So I was real proud of those guys for that.
Alright, let's go ahead and take a look at some of the highlights from the contest last Saturday night. Unusual feeling, the fact that it was on a Saturday. I think everybody in Marion was here just about. They weren't at the Popcorn Festival.
Yeah, there was a lot of people there, and it was just like the Cam McKinley games back in the day. Yeah. Right here we have A.J. Jones and L.J. in the backfield. Running a stretch play, just trying to get our athletes in space, trying to outrun them, and it was a pretty good result here. The next one here, I think we run a misdirection counterplay with LJ. Kind of get the defense flowing. We knew they were real aggressive. We bring them back here and get a good run. And what I like to see is him finish the run here. A lot of backs will go out of bounds, but he let those kids know that he was here to play. So that was good on his part. Next one here is going to be pass to the flats, something we've worked on ever since camp, getting Logan Crawford. That's a big guy, but he has some pretty soft hands, and he likes to lower that boom. He's one of the tougher players on the team. Next here, we slant by Versace Backus. He had a really good game. He's come a long way since the start of camp, and is a kid who's really going to be making some big-time plays for us here in the near future. Right here we have LJ up the middle, just giving that second effort, which he does every single down, and that gets the crowd kind of into it and lets those guys know, hey, it's going to be a long day. Next we have Keontae taking it in for the touchdown. Kobe's real excited, and we finally get on the board here. A little bit of defense. I was probably on the sideline getting things ready to go, but we got a good stick right there by our kicker and linebacker, which you usually don't see that combination. I believe this is our second touchdown of the day. A little boot action. Got our senior Nathan Endo scoring a touchdown, getting him on the board. He's put a lot of great effort into the blocking aspect, and it was nice to finally get him a catch. This, I believe, was the two-point conversion we went for. Kobe just being an athlete that he is, making a play, you know, protecting the ball, and that's something that has gone unnoticed, but we really haven't turned the ball over in the last couple of games, and that's something that we emphasize each and every day. Hey, protect the ball and live to play the next play. So real proud of those guys for protecting the ball the last couple of weeks.
You mentioned Kobe, and I know he was under a lot of pressure on Saturday night, but boy, if you can get him into space, he can make a lot happen.
That's the thing that's really surprising, is because I never knew that Kobe was the runner that he is, and he's not asked to do a lot of running. He's not asked to make a lot of plays, but when it's time for him to make a play, when it is, he is ready, and we're real proud that he's you know, not making huge mistakes and getting rid of the ball.
Being on a Saturday game, how does that affect your preparation for Friday's game against Mansfield Senior?
It was a quick turnaround, but some of the coaches, we weren't looking past the River Valley game, but we had some things that we needed to square up for next week, and just to minimize the time we'd spend in the office on Sunday. So we had everything squared up for the River Valley game and prepped a little bit for the next game, just so we could not lose a day.
Normally you'll have the kids come in on Saturday and kind of view game film and so forth. Was that moved back then to Monday?
Sunday we did have treatment for the guys. You know, if you were beat up a little bit, you were more than welcome to come in. And just a real good day to reflect on kind of, you know, where you want to go from here. It's not time to pack in. It's kind of time to take it to the next level. So we had some guys come in. We had some guys put in some extra work. And we had a great practice Monday night.
All right, very good. Appreciate you being on.
Thank you.
We'll be back with more on the Coach's Corner program right after these words.
Let's Let's talk real natural beauty. It's elegant. It's effortless. It's Cambria Natural Quartz Surfaces. I love Cambria because it makes any room drop-dead gorgeous. And yet it's incredibly care-free. No sealing, no polishing, no special cleanup. And since Cambria Quartz is naturally long-lasting, it just gets better over time. Now that's a beautiful thing indeed. See for yourself the true beauty of Cambria.
Back once again on the Coach's Corner program. This is the segment where we talk to some of the players. We have three seniors up here. We got Brent Price, Alex Thompson, and Brent Bennett to my right. Go ahead and kind of start down on the end. Talk about positions that you play.
Well, I'm the quick tackle on the offense, and also have been recently learning linebacker. The Mike and our coaches are also putting me at. They're wanting me to learn Sam and Will too. So. Be stepping up on defense a little bit, but offense is my home position.
Talk a little bit for a lot of the viewers maybe that aren't into a lot of football terminology. Is there such a thing as a slow tackler?
No, you always have to be a quick tackler. You always have to get into it and drive through it. Can't ever be slow on your feet or you won't get that tackle to save the game.
Talk a little bit about you play offense and defense.
Yep.
Do you have a preference?
I like offense more. I'm more confident with that. That's my first position that I learned, and I'm pretty good at tackle, and I just like being on the offense with Coach Filiator.
You're a couple weeks into the season. Talk a little bit about where you and where you think the team stand at this point.
I think our team stands pretty well right now. We still need to work on a few things, and our offense needs to step it up, and so does our defense. But right now we're a good structured team. We just need to focus a little bit more and work a little bit harder.
Yeah, you talk about the structure. You mentioned Coach Filiator. Obviously, he's got some pretty good structure there.
Yep, Coach Filiator, he's the O-line coach. He's been coaching for us for a while. Well, he came back this year, but he said he's coached before here at Harding. And he has really good ideas, and he's really good at helping us learn, like, go through the offensive drills and teaching us new things about offense that we've never learned before.
You know, taking nothing away from last year's team, but is this year the attitude of the field just a little bit different?
Yeah, it's a little bit more team focused. Last year, I think we were a little bit individualized. So this year, we're a little bit more of a team. I think we're a little closer. So that helps a lot.
And the midget football just had their opening last Sunday. You played, I remember you playing midget football. You played for the Dolphins.
Yep.
All right, excellent. Appreciate you being on. You played for?
The Vikings.
The Vikings, okay. Obviously, you enjoyed your time at midget football.
Yeah.
I know LJ was there last Sunday, gave a little inspirational talk to the kids. Talk a little bit about your position/positions.
I play receiver and corner for us. And and I play almost on all special teams.
So when it's 93 degrees like it's going to be today, or when it's been hot and humid the last couple of Friday nights or last week of Saturday night, you got to be in pretty good shape.
Yeah, you have to drink all the water you can, try to eat banana, just keep them on potassium and try not to cramp up.
All right. I know that was an issue last week for both teams. In fact, it was a hot night, a little humid, and the cramp is just one of those things you kind of got to get your way through it.
Yeah, you can't. If you start cramping up but you feel like it's a close game or that you really want to win, you just got to try to stay in the game and do whatever you can.
Offense, defense, which do you prefer and why?
I'd say I prefer defense more than offense because I've been playing defense for us and started corner since my sophomore year. And I've just always liked it more just because you can just go and hit someone instead of offense. Feels like it's more controlled.
You know, as a receiver and then playing a defensive back or whatever, is that kind of an advantage sometimes where if you're on offense, you can kind of maybe look at the defensive back's eyes, kind of see which way they're headed, or if you're a corner or defensive back, kind of look at the receiver and kind of just get a feel as far as which way they're going to go?
Yeah, you can, after playing receiver and trying to be a corner, it makes it a lot easier because you can anticipate the routes a little bit better, and you can get a feel for what they're going to do, if they're going to block or pass, whatever, and it makes the job a lot easier.
All right, excellent. Give us a quick scouting report on Mansfield Senior Friday night.
Mansfield Senior has a quarterback who likes to pass a lot, which will be nice for me so I can try to get a few interceptions. They don't like to run the ball too much, and their quarterback runs a little bit, but that's about it.
All right, nice job. Appreciate you being on.
Thank you.
I'm going to kind of talk to you a little bit. You're a wide receiver.
Yes, I am.
Talk a little bit about being a wide receiver in the offense this year.
Well, this is my first year playing for high school, and I thought it would be nice to try for something I've always wanted to do. In middle school, I never played, so I figured I'd play my last year of high school.
It's got to be a tough adjustment you know, not playing, and all of a sudden you're going up against, you know, guys that, you know, maybe have been playing since, you know, fourth grade or whatever. Just how difficult is that adjustment?
It's pretty difficult. These people have been playing their whole life, you know, and I have to learn how to play with them and learn the plays and everything.
What's the biggest thing that maybe you have been surprised about as far as being a receiver? Is it maybe the quickness of the game?
Probably what it takes to learn the plays, you know. I mean, it's easy to forget the plays, so you have to be, you know, smart and quick about it.
The fact that you haven't had a lot of experience, the coach has maybe given you a little extra break? You're hesitating.
I don't know, maybe. I like to think that.
Okay. You know, a couple weeks into the season, pleased that you came out for the team?
Yeah, I'm pretty happy I came out for the team. I scored a touchdown in JV the other week. So.
All right, so one of your highlights then. Hopefully we can get you in and maybe score a touchdown on the varsity.
Yep.
Okay, appreciate you being on. That wasn't so bad. Appreciate all three of our guests being on. We'll come back, wrap up this edition of the Coach's Corner program right after these words.
It's been said men tend to communicate shoulder to shoulder. If that's the case, these guys are saying, let's change the world. Let's make a difference. Let's act as we are called. The Knights of Columbus, in service to one, in service to all.
Once again, back on the Coach's Corner program. And
Coach, I know I was talking with Dick Brown last week during the game. I know there's kind of some extra celebration. They're welcoming back the basketball class of 63 this Friday night, going to do some tailgating and so forth. So I know for some of our viewers, especially who have been around a while, it'd be good to kind of welcome most of those players back.
Well, it's always great to get those guys to come back. And, you know, it goes again, shows you how much pride they have in Marion Harding High School. We're also having a Coach Mack and Carol Bebout is also will be our honorary captains, so it'll be a good night.
Talk a little bit about a very good Mansfield senior ball club.
Yes, very good. Very talented. It might be the best skilled group Mansfield's had in a very long time. Quarterback's a heck of a player, and he's got four or five receivers he can throw to at any time. Good running game, and their defense is relentless. They can fly to the ball. And, you know, we got a game plan. We have to stick to our game plan, and we're really happy with it. We just have to execute it, and like Alex said, we have to focus. And don't get upset, because, you know, everything's not going to be peaches and cream out there. We have to focus and just execute the best we can.
Primarily pass and then the run game second?
Yes, and I tell you what, we're going to have to just really be disciplined this week. And whatever works for us early, we're going to have to change, because they will adjust at halftime and they'll try to shut us down.
All right, John, appreciate you being on. Let's get it turned around, and hopefully we can talk about better things next week.
All right, thank you.
Got to wrap it up for this edition of the Coach's Corner program. For head coach John Brady, I'm Jeff Ruth.